In the 20th century, a powerful explosion occurred in central eastern Chile. As a plume of ash rose to a height of 30.5 kilometers or 100,000 feet, pyroclastic flows raced across the landscape, incinerating all vegetation in their path. As this plume of ash drifted towards the east, it eventually fell on western Argentina before reaching the city of General Pico and covering it in 10 centimeters thick of ash. Eventually, it reached Buenos Aires in the Atlantic Ocean 1,140 kilometers or 708 miles away, where a half a centimeter thick of ash fell. The vast majority of this ash fell in a single 18-hour period on April 10th, even causing a dusting to occur in sections of Uruguay, Paraguay, and even Brazil. By the time this eruption completely ceased 11 days later, a grand total of 9.52 billion cubic meters of primarily ash had coated an area of 4.27 million square kilometers, or about 3.3% of the Earth's landmass. Yet, despite producing what would go on to be the fourth largest explosive volcanic eruption of the entire 20th century and affecting millions of people, this eruption would largely be forgotten, possibly due to it taking place during the peak of the Great Depression in 1932. This eruption occurred at the Cerro Azul volcano, which can be found in central eastern Chile, where it is 85 kilometers east of the city of Talca. The Cerro Azul complex not only consists of a central stratocone, but also four flank explosion craters, two cinder cones, and two lava fields. While Cerro Azul has produced almost every single type of eruption imaginable during the last 340,000 years, there is a decent possibility that this volcano is even older. As there is circumstantial evidence not only linking Cerro Azul to what is considered to be the separate Descapizado Grande volcano, but also the fact that it exists in close proximity to what is believed to be a more than 20-kilometer-wide caldera, 800,000 years old, from the presumably active Calabozos volcano. While these indeed might be three separate systems, they appear to have some form of a joint link at depth, possibly in the lowermost crust where a shared large volume magma chamber may exist. The main cone of Cerro Azul began erupting 340,000 years ago, ejecting quantities of basaltic andesite lava and scoria in a moderately explosive manner. It would have been quite scenic to see this volcano in that stage, as it almost completely consisted of Strombolian eruptions. Yet, over time, this volcano's eruptions became more explosive, involving Vulcanian explosions, and now generated andesite lava flows. These andesite lava flows coated the landscape in a 5-mile or 8-kilometer radius over the next 300,000 years, with the black lava flows from this event being exposed just below the modern surface ignimbrite layer. Possibly around 40,000 years ago, the main cone ceased erupting, with now less frequent but more explosive eruptions occurring at flank vents. Although two less explosive cinder cone-forming eruptions occurred, there were also three highly explosive mar-forming eruptions which carved out between 700 and 1100-meter-wide craters during a period lasting from 25,000 to 10,000 years ago. Then, this volcano laid inactive for around 10,000 years until a new flank vent known as Quizapu unexpectedly erupted on November 26, 1846. A large volume of dacite lava then began flowing out, and over the next year would cover 54.4 square kilometers and a total of 5 cubic kilometers of material. Surprisingly, this eruption had a high gas content, but was only moderately explosive, as injected andesite magma into the magma chamber before the eruption allowed the dacite to be unusually low viscosity. Once this eruption ended, the majority of gas in the underlying shallow magma chamber had been expelled, but this had an unexpected consequence, as this gas at depth had in fact absorbed the intruding magma without causing overlying rock to catastrophically break. Now no longer the case, it was only a matter of time before a moderate gas content yet highly explosive eruption occurred. Ever-increasing explosive eruptions then subsequently occurred between 1906 and 1932 until the climactic Plinian eruption took place. The 1932 eruption was highly explosive as the sheer pressure of the magma squeezed into the tight space caused overlying rock to fracture, eventually causing the erupting lava to fragment into many fine particles of ash. After this, three smaller eruptions occurred, with the last such event occurring in 1967. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron Morua Smith-Miski for supporting this channel.